been a long time. I shouldn't have left you without a dope beat. Step two, step two. Good morning and salutations, everybody. And of course, hey girl, hey. Today we are going to be talking about the new release from IT Cosmetics. You guys have been asking, and I heard you. This is the Confidence in a Foundation Foundation. Sounds a little funny. Can we welcome the newest member of our class? Everyone say hello to Miss Microfiber Plant. I got this on Amazon. This is from one of my favorite hair accessory brands. And it also has a little hole in the back if you want to tie your hair while you're using it. So it's on my Amazon store with all my Amazon favorites if you haven't checked it out. It's always in my info box. In a nutshell, this foundation is a oil-free, full coverage, long wearing, 48 shades, retails for $32, and it is supposed to be great for all skin types, even those with the most sensitive skin. And can I add that she's also weightless in claim? It claims to cover everything we need, you know, the redness, the blemishes, and all that without cracking, creasing, or fading. We've heard it before. Let's see if it happens. I picked up one shade, so yes, I am testing my luck. This is Medium Sand 210. It is a warm shade, and it is the last shade that I reviewed from IT Cosmetics, which was a Perfecto Prime in the Pump. Ha! She's moving a little bit. Just a little. Oh, there she goes. Please don't fall off. Let's hope this shade sets to what I need it to. I really hope the shades are consistent though, because Medium Sand was so good to me last time. I was so shook and impressed. If you haven't seen that review, go ahead and check it out. It's one of the best matching shades I've ever tried, and I'm hoping this one will do the same. Hold on. Hold on. Thinking about it. That was medium tan. I retract my statements. I was like, something sounds funny. Medium sand, medium tan. This one is looking a little lighter, but I definitely am not just medium straight up in their foundation. This is probably the medium that's a little warmer, so I thought that would work for me in the winter time. Medium tan is definitely me more in the summer. So we are gonna continue on. Before, and here's a little after. After further review of the shade range, there is no medium tan, so that perfect match I'm searching for from their other product is not gonna happen right here, especially under the same name. But if you do go to the IT Cosmetics website, you can click just the medium shades and they will pull the medium 9 shades, and then you can see each tone. So the next shade that is warm up would be medium honey, which I typically don't get shades that say honey. And to me, from the picture and the swatch, it has more of an overly warm glow. But if you are not in winter mode, twinsies, then you might have to try that shade, because the one after that definitely doesn't look like the perfect golden tone. It definitely looks overly warm too, and that's also called medium warm. I have a plethora of different IT Cosmetics brushes. This one is dirty right now, the typical flat top. I'm gonna use more of a dome round one, but this is called their airbrush foundation brush. You guys can see the condition of my skin is not as nice as it was before. If you haven't been keeping up to date, if you don't follow me on Instagram or don't pay attention to the pinned comments or info box down below. The last foundation I reviewed on my channel was the new Tarte Face Tape Foundation, the new 50 shades, etc., etc., blah, blah, blah. Y'all were dying for it. Every time Tarte releases something, a lot of people just freak out. So I tested it out, and lo and behold, I broke out horribly. And when your girl says horribly, here's some picture proof. I had pimples all on my lip. I have this huge flat scar now. Generally, they were all really painful, cystic, very deep. The second the foundation came off and the air hit my skin, I was itchy, scratchy. I was so unhappy. And then for the next few days, every day, every few hours, I'd get 5 to 7 pimples. And that was probably the worst reaction I've had to a foundation. My skin has been, for the most part, in one of the best conditions it has been prior to that. So I personally do not want to risk it with the new Tarte release. They came out with another product right away within a month of the last one. Don't have any plans on reviewing the new Tarte foundation anymore, because I did a poll on my IG and at least 92% of people said, protect your skin, girl, worry about yourself. it's okay, there'll be other people to review Tarte. And there was like 8% of people who are like, I don't give a damn if you break out, girl. We need our reviews. And it wasn't just me. A lot of people who were reviewers also broke out from the foundation, also break out a lot from Tarte. I do prefer a sponge. So this is what we are at now. So we basically had a pump on each side of the face, but it did cover everything. I would say this coverage is full because I barely can see any acne scars at all. The finish does not seem velvety matte to me. It looks hydrated and dewy. I think this is closer to what their CC cream in the silver tube looks like compared to the CC matte. Surprisingly, this foundation does not have SPF, and It Cosmetics is known to have them high numbers on us. They don't do anything like under 30 SPF. Usually it's 50, 55, something like that. I'm pretty sure this is gonna photograph beautifully, but let's just test it anyway. So I thought there was some sort of white cast of some sort, but it's more an actual reflection of the dewiness of the foundation that is showing in the pictures. So I guess that could technically count as a flashback because it is flashing off of the reflection, but typically flashback is more reference to for more of that white cast caused by pigments in foundation. So it's more just some dewy. I am liking the shade a lot now. I approve it for my twinsies. Initial thoughts would be it is definitely not the finish I assumed it would have. It feels lightweight on the face and the full coverage is there. As far as looking flawless goes, I would say yeah, but I'm getting some weird texture. You guys can see it, right? It's like you can see just kind of like a little bit of pore accentuation and a little bit of crinkling kind of going on from there. And that's a little odd to me. It's not as smooth. It feels like it might be sitting a little above my skin compared to mashed well and meshed together. I would say mesh. It does accentuate overall texture, but I still, because of the hydrated finish, look moisturized. That makes sense. So down my nose bridge, I look really good, but everywhere else, like, it has more of like lines and something. It's not super sticky, but it doesn't feel like it's gonna hang around longer than 3 hours if I don't set at least my oily areas. So I'm gonna finish up my face and add concealer, setting powder under the eyes, and probably a loose dusting of translucent powder around my face. And otherwise, I will see you guys at the end of thy day. We're back. It's been 8 hours. And if you're interested in seeing what I wore on the rest of my face, I got a little Instagram video, so make sure you go check out my Instagram, because usually I try to make a little video, be a good reference point, and also give you guys some Instagram content. So here we are. What do you guys think? First impressions, This is the first time I've been looking at it. I took the picture, so I'm gonna put those on the screen right now. I'm not gonna say too much about the shade because I talked about it earlier, but the shade is still good and it's still the shade I would repick and pick for those who wear the same shade as me typically. After 8 hours with no primer, we definitely still have full coverage. All of my scarring all over is still covered. I'm not having too much of an issue with any pores, really. Like, for the most part, it got better throughout the day, at least in this triangular eye area. Keep in mind, there is the Too Faced concealer in that eye area, so it is meshing well with other products. I also wore a L'Oreal concealer as a cream contour today, and generally had no issues blending on top of this foundation. This foundation has a weightless claim. I will say that it is pretty lightweight, and I can agree with that. I am starting to feel it more and more now that we're getting into the higher number hour-wise, but for the most part, it is on the lighter end of the spectrum. And for the most part, I will agree with the fact that it says it's long wear, because we are getting, you know, 8 hours and such, and it's not missing any areas, which is more than a lot of other foundations I've reviewed recently can say. I also am a little surprised that the velvety matte finish wasn't as matte as I guess I imagined. I don't need a super matte formula. I'm not that girl. I don't need matte, you know, but velvety matte didn't translate into dewy to me. That was probably one of the dewier finishes I've had in the past few reviews, so that was surprising for something that wasn't advertised anywhere near even like a satin, you know. But when they start saying satin and velvet, we get into fabrics. I think I would have changed velvety matte to healthy, moisturized, something like that finish. But I know you guys felt it coming. There is a but. I'm not really a fan of how it creates a really textured peach fuzz appearance that doesn't seem to be getting better. If anything, it is getting worse, especially just the surrounding, like upper lip to the chin area. It's also doing it on my forehead, and if I look closely, the sides, basically almost all over, but yeah, the sides of my cheeks as well. It has just a clingy formula, and I don't experience this very often. I rarely mention peach fuzz, so it is definitely something noticeable enough that I want to mention it for those who do suffer from that, because I do get questions about that all the time. Like, some formulas are just more prone to clinging on to even the thinnest of facial hair. So if you already have that issue, I would avoid this formula because you won't enjoy it. I never notice it, but right now it's what would change this foundation from that I love it moment. I would give it like an A minus, because an A plus, I think you really gotta earn it without this issue, but with this issue, it definitely is like more of a B minus grade for me right now, because overall it's killing the appearance. Even from a distance, I don't look as smooth, you know. It's creating maybe some micro moments in the foundation, which, because there's so many, I don't look baby bottom, but I could. I can appreciate that it's not sitting in my pores, but it is creating little lines, you know, in the forehead, little lines on the lip, anywhere that has lots of motion. It's not settling so well, which is surprising to me, because for the most part, its cosmetic products never do that. I mean, that's major con in the Confidence Foundation. Can I just call it that? Confidence Foundation. 48 shades is just unheard of for them, so I applaud them for giving this foundation the amount of shades that they felt like was needed for everyone. And I can't speak for the range, but from just an overall glimpse, it doesn't look bad. Overall, I will give it a very like light stamp of approval, like barely any ink on the paper approval, because it's not bad, it's just not it. Chief, the one con is a big one, and I won't reach for it again, because I don't like seeing such texture, especially because I saw it right away with the foundation. It could have been something special. I hope you guys enjoyed watching today's video on this new It Cosmetics foundation. Thank you guys as always for watching. Just so you know, the next review coming at y'all is the CoverGirl Full Spectrum line. Make sure you stay tuned for that upcoming drugstore content, as well as other videos. Make sure you're subscribed if you haven't yet, and feel free to click thy bell down below if you feel like you're missing out on my videos. And that's about it for me. If you want to check out my most recent uploads, they'll be over here. I'll see y'all in a later one.